Good morning, children. Today we are going to do The Little Bird. This is chapter 8 from your treetop book. Alright, now if you turn to this chapter, it is in page number 57. The little bird, if you see here this picture, okay, you all were asked to write about these two birds yesterday, and many of you have given very interesting answers. This bird, as we see, is probably a nightingale who is sitting and who is in full throat is singing a song, right? Now, you imagine, when will you sing a song? Probably when you are alone, probably when you are in a very happy mood or in a sad mood, okay? So, you will sing a song, a happy song, when you are in a very, very happy or in a good mood. Now, if this very bird who is enjoying its freedom, who is singing its song, who is flying high in the sky, is not allowed to do so, do you think this bird will be happy anymore? No. This bird, the same bird, suppose I keep it in the cage, see, it has become mute. That means it will no more sing the song of happiness. It has stopped enjoying its life. Though to me, I am glad that it is my pet now. But is it in its natural habitat? No, it is not in its natural habitat. Its natural habitat are the trees, the branches of the trees, the fruits that it eats from the trees. Can it enjoy any such thing anymore? No. So whenever you are putting a bird to a cage, you know, in earlier days, even many people, they keep either a dog or a cat, or sometimes, you know, the king would keep a cheetah or a tiger. So in all the cases, we may be a very proud owner of the pet, but do you think the animal would equally enjoy that? Think again. Now this story, this little bird, alright, this little bird, the story starts in, this is about a boy, okay, and his name is Seryozha. Now as you see, Seryozha, the name is very uncommon, right? I'll just put the camera this way. The name is a bit uncommon. Why? Because it's a Russian name. Now if you see who is the author, the author is Leo Tolstoy. And Leo Tolstoy is a Russian writer. Okay? His favorite writings are, you know, his story, the novel, that is Love and War. And he would write about a person's feelings. Not only just a person's feeling. Do you think only human beings can feel? Even animals can also feel, right? So this story, this short story, is about one such bird and about its feelings. Let us see. Once, now whenever you are reading the story, children, always remember that you take a pencil, alright? So once there lived a little boy called Seryozha. On his birthday, Seryozha received many gifts, which included picture books, tops, and hobby horses. His uncle gifted him a trap for snaring birds, which he prized above all the other gifts. This trap had a frame and a little boat attached to it, and a net that was held back. So what we find? That Seryozha is just a young boy like you. And on your birthday, how you receive gifts from your loved ones, same way Seryozha also receives many, many gifts, which included picture books, tops, and hobby horses. Right? Now, the one gift that he prized above all the others, that means the one that was his favorite or which he treasured the most, is the bird trap. This bird trap was gifted by his uncle. And what did it contain? It had a board. You know, a board is like a flat surface, and it had a frame with a net. So the bird will come and sit on the board, and the net will fall upon the bird. Now, why the bird will come and sit on the board? Probably you will give some grains or something, and the bird will be lured to come and sit on the board, right? As soon as the bird sits on the board, the net will fall upon it. Okay? Seriosa's little mind was filled with happiness, and he showed the gift to his mother. His mother was not happy to see it. She did not like the idea of keeping birds in a cage and torturing them. Now you have to understand that Seriosa is young, and therefore his experience of life is very less. He is adventurous, he is excited, and he thinks it is great to trap a bird. But his mother, who is a sensitive soul, you know, a mother who has a lot of experiences of her life, she says it is not really a good idea. Why? Because if you put a bird in a cage, it is like torturing them. What do you mean by torture? Means to be cruel to them. Okay? Will the bird enjoy the life anymore? No. But do you think Seriosa listened to his mother? But Seriosa was bent on catching the bird and feeding it. He thought it's a great idea. The next day, he scattered some seeds on the board and kept the trap on the garden. On seeing him, the birds were scared. What do you mean by scared? Afraid. So please underline, and you have to write above, afraid. And they did not come near the net. After waiting for a long time, he went home to have dinner. Okay, dinner, the final meal in the evening. When he returned, he found a little bird inside. Seriosa was extremely delighted. See, I've underlined extremely delighted. Now, when you are very happy, how do you express it? I am so happy, right? But there are many other words, you know, like delighted, or you can also say overjoyed, right? So you can write about delighted, overjoyed, OVERJOYED. Okay, extremely happy, extremely delighted, overjoyed, ecstatic. There are many words, and whenever you are writing an essay, it is best to use this kind of words. He could feel the little bird's heartbeat. He immediately took the bird to his mother. He thought it was a nightingale. Nightingale, I saw you the picture. I showed you the picture, the page before. The blackbird, right? Which is a songbird, and it sings beautifully. But what did the mother say? No, it is not a nightingale. No, it is a siskin. See, this is the dialogue that the mother says. So the dialogue is always written within inverted comma. See, the comma is inverted like this, right? So inverted comma open, inverted comma close. Within this, the dialogue is written, said his mother. And after the dialogue, one comma is there. Said his mother, Seriosa, please don't torture the bird. See, again another dialogue. So inverted comma open. Seriosa, please don't torture the bird. Let it go. Now in a story, if the writer uses a lot of dialogues, it becomes very interesting. You can almost imagine the mother saying these words, right? So that is why direct speech or dialogues are often used in the story to make it interesting. So do you think Seryozha's mother really approved of his idea of keeping a pet? No. She said that it is very cruel. It is almost like torturing the bird. But Seryozha was not in a mood to listen. Right? He did not pay heed to his mother's advices. So, what happens next, we will read next time. Thank you.